Tell us what you can about the Orion.
Well, Wolf, this is the Orion right now. It's towed on cables like this. It can scan the ocean floor about 3/4 of a mile in each direction, and it can go much deeper than the Bluefin can go. Many analysts believe if the Bluefin can't find wreckage of the missing plane, this should be the next vehicle in the water. The Bluefin 21 has scoured the search area, pushed the limits of its depth capability, and so far found nothing. But the ocean floor is deeper in some places than the Bluefin can go, and this may be the next best option.
This is Orion system. It's the Navy's towed side scan sonar system.
We got a behind-the-scenes look at the Orion at Phoenix International, the undersea search team which operates the towed pinger locator and the Bluefin 21. The U.S. Navy owns the Orion. Phoenix runs and maintains it. Project manager Mark Heinrich showed us the Orion and the Curve, a remotely operated vehicle that can recover wreckage. Their advantage over the Bluefin? Orion can go a mile deeper, about 3.7 miles down, can stay down much longer, days or weeks at a time, unlike the Bluefin's 24 hours. It's towed with a cable, so it's not as bothered by rough seas caused by bad weather. Orion doesn't have a camera like the Bluefin does, but does have side-scan sonar.
The deucers that send out the signal, which basically it sends out a sound signal to the seafloor, and that sound signal bounces off the seafloor and comes back, which paints a picture of the bottom of the ocean.
And there's another advantage for Orion.
One key capability that the Orion has, which the Bluefin does not have, is the ability to transmit images and data in real time. That gets sent up here to a control room on the surface of the ship, where a pilot and co-pilot of the Orion are watching it in real time, looking at the images, sometimes taking a screen grab and analyzing it on a different screen.
If the Orion spots something, it's taken out and the Curve is sent in. The Curve can spot wreckage in the pitch dark.
They're floodlights, basically. They'll light up as far as the ROV can see on the seafloor.
And can pick debris up with its manipulator arms. So why wasn't this system used immediately in this search?
To move Curve, Orion, their handling systems, you're talking about 300,000 pounds of equipment, several aircraft to move all of this stuff, and then the deck space on ship to be able to operate it all.
Now, officials here say these vehicles are ready to deploy to the Indian Ocean if they're requested. They have to be ready on about 4 hours' notice. It takes about 3 days to fly them to the Indian Ocean, Wolf, and they say it might take another week to deploy them.
They're getting ready, though, presumably. What are some of the limitations, though, Brian, of the Orion?
Well, officials here say that it's got, it cannot go to the very bottom of the ocean. It's got to be elevated at about maybe 1,000 feet off the ocean floor because it's towed and it does not have the ability to kind of zigzag in inconsistent patterns like the Bluefin can, but it stays down much longer. But because it's towed, it's got to go in that lawnmower pattern, and it can sometimes hit a hill or a mountain on the ocean floor. It's been known to do that on occasion. But again, it can stay down a lot longer, and it's got much greater depth capability than the Bluefin.